Hi, Andrew Tanielian here. Today you're going to learn something really useful. How to record what you're doing on your computer is video using the screen capture program Screenflow. This is a great way to showcase how to do something, like how you use a particular program on your computer or how to navigate your website. It's also used a lot to show you hidden tricks and hidden levels in video games or simply how to conquer them. But most importantly, it's a way to make a video that you don't have to be in. Here we are on my desktop, and to begin capturing what's going on my screen as video, we first have to go into ScreenFlow, and it is conveniently down here in my dock, so I click on ScreenFlow, and it activates that. And notice here how you get this very small gray box, but dead center so you can see it. This is the first thing anybody sees when they go into ScreenFlow, a little different than other applications that you're used to. Some options here, you want to, where it says record from desktop, you want it from, if you're on a laptop, your color LCD. If you have other monitors hooked up to this, if this is on a desktop computer, if you go into that drop-down menu, you will see other options and other monitors listed. So depending upon which action you want to be recording for this particular recording session, you can choose which one you want, which is very nice. Your second option here is that you can record video from an external video source. And what that means, the first one you see listed here, because I'm on a laptop, is my FaceTime HD camera, which all Apple laptops have embedded in the top of their screen. They're very similar to, if you have an iPad or an iPhone, there's that camera on the front. And ScreenFlow recognizes this and asks me, hey, if you actually want to record from that source, we'll go ahead and not only turn it on, but then we'll also start recording video from there and not record what's going on your screen. So to activate that, all I have to do is go and click that checkbox. Similar thing with audio. You can hook up external mics to your computer and record from those as well. Or if you want to, also record the audio from your internal microphone. And most desktops have an internal microphone somewhere, but if the actual computer is farther away from you than not, that's not going to be your best option. When you're talking about a laptop, because laptops hide the microphone underneath the speaker, it's right by the keyboard, and because you have to type, your laptop is always very close to you. So I have both the record video from and the record audio from checkbox unclicked, because when I record a program on my computer, whether it be a how to use Adobe Photoshop or Apple Final Cut Pro, I want the video that's being recorded coming from my monitor. You want to click the checkbox record computer audio. So when something plays back on the computer, or the computer makes a certain alert sound or a sound that's important to what you're doing, I want you as the audience to hear what I'm hearing from my computer. If I wanted to make my production process simpler and also check the record audio from the built-in microphone or a microphone of my choice, I would be recording two kinds of audio, the kind from my computer and then also the kind that's coming through my microphone, which is something if you guys are doing how-tos, a how to use my app or how this app integrates into this process, or perhaps you are showcasing your website and how to navigate, things like that, then you're going to want to check both of those boxes. And when you start recording, you get this new pop-up box, and it's a countdown. And the countdown, mine starts at 2, yours will start at 5. The default setting for ScreenFlow is to give you 5 seconds of countdown time before it automatically starts recording. And once it does, all you have to do is just start doing whatever it was that you want to do. And what we'll do here, we'll go into my programs here, and what do I want to teach you guys today? What haven't I taught before? Let's go into Apple Maps, because I want to show you just how easy it is to use Apple Maps if you're on an Apple computer. And here's a region of Dallas, Texas, far north Dallas. Here's the Glen Eagles Country Club. Here's the shops at Willow Bend. But let's say I want to go, oh boy, let's say I want directions. Where should we go? Downtown Dallas. Now you're ready to stop recording. And the way that you got to do that, it said this in the countdown window, but if it went by too fast, you guys probably won't remember, nor did I for the first several times I was recording. You want to hit 3 buttons on the keyboard at once. It's It's going to be Shift, Command, and the number 2. And when you do that, it stops recording and then pulls your recording into ScreenFlow, throws your recording onto a timeline, so if you want it to start editing, all you gotta do is select your clip, hover over this yellow space with this double arrow, and just start trimming the front and also the back to whatever your liking is. And that's it. That is how to start and end a screen capture with the screen capture program, ScreenFlow. And there are other videos in this playlist that go through simple editing, advanced editing, and the all-important export and upload to wherever you want on the web. If you want it on YouTube, I go through YouTube, Vimeo, I go through Vimeo, and also if you want to store this on your personal website, we talk about a file format, the way in which ScreenFlow allows you to do something like that. So I'll see you soon. To get your own copy of ScreenFlow, click the link in the description box below. And while you're there, click the thumbs up icon to like this video and leave me a comment below telling me what other videos you want to see. To subscribe, click the top video. To learn more cool stuff, click the bottom one.